Zero Day. This starts with shipping from reception. Soldiers line up with their full duffel bags and personal belongings waiting to be checked off by their new command. Next, personal bags go on one truck, and recruits with their duffel bags on troop transport. Arriving at their new home, they file off and are met by the drill sergeants that will be responsible to turn them from a civilian into a soldier. Soon, all you hear is, "Yes, drill sergeant, no drill sergeant." Heads down and off we go. The Team Development Course, or TDC, has 6 separate complex tasks to complete. Each obstacle tests the team's ingenuity and how well they can work together in solving the obstacles with the given tools in the allotted time. If an individual fails, the whole team fails. This really teaches that there is no I in team. Communication is the life link of any operation. During communications training, soldiers learn the proper use of radios and telephones in current use. They also learn proper transmission procedures, as well as maintenance of the equipment. The Warrior Tower tests the Army value of personal courage, facing fear, danger, or adversity. Soldiers will learn to tie their own Swiss seat made of park cord, and practice to rappel down the 40-foot wall on the mini wall first. This mini wall will work out all the techniques and questions soldiers may have before they take the plunge down the bigger wall. CBRN, also known as chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear, is an integral part of any soldier's training. Prompt recognition and reaction to any of these hazards are vital. CBRN Day starts off with a 4-hour instructional class. Soldiers are taught how to prepare and pack their masks. At the end of classroom training, on the instructor's command, the soldiers will unpack their masks and cover their faces in the most time-efficient manner possible. We'll be right back. CBRN training, also known as the gas chamber, is where practical training and the proper use of the protective mask during a gas exposure is put into action. When the drill instructor yells gas, 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 the chamber starts. Soldiers file into the chamber, which is filled with fumes from a heated tablet that contains ingredients used to make CS gas, a non-lethal riot control tear gas. Soldiers are then put through a series of exercises that are meant to check for leaks and produce labored breathing, thus proving the protective mask is working. The drill instructor then instructs the soldiers to lift their masks to expose their eyes, nose, and mouth. The soldiers will then seal their masks and clear them by blowing the gas out through the vents. Once the soldiers are comfortable breathing again, the drill instructors have them remove their masks one more time and hold them into the air and file into formation. After that, they will exit the chamber in a calm but urgent manner. As the soldiers leave the chamber, they are instructed to circle the pit two times while flapping their arms and blinking their eyes. This helps remove any lingering fumes they might have left on them. The CS gas leaves their system, usually in less than a minute. First aid encompasses several days of intense training in certain procedures, such as wound care, securing airways, CPR, tourniquets, and wounded soldier evacuation. Teaching soldiers to become self-reliant when the situation arises is critical. These are all life-saving need-to-knows that can come handy in emergencies, not just on the battlefield but in everyday situations. The Confidence Course is a series of obstacles soldiers negotiate with their company. This course gives soldiers confidence in their mental and physical abilities while cultivating their spirit of daring. The obstacles vary from easy to difficult, testing their balance, physical strength, and mental endurance. In addition, the course offers them perspective on how basic training has helped prepare them for live combat situations. Each phase ends with FTX, where previous instructions are culminated and put into action. During FTX, soldiers live in tents, eat food prepared in the field, and practice their skills in the forward battle zone. Each soldier will train at EST, Engagement Skills Trainer, multiple times to better understand their personal firing techniques and get a better understanding of how to prepare their weapon before shooting at the live range. Exercises at the EST location help to instill confidence, ownership, and responsibility between a soldier and their rifle. The development of a soldier's skills in the use of the Army's individual weapon, the M4, depends entirely on the soldier's ability to apply the marksmanship skills and principles taught and reinforced by the drill sergeant. The rifle becomes the soldier's tool in the profession of arms. Like any other profession, the use of knowledge of the two must become second nature. The soldier must learn about his weapon from the inside out. Rifle marksmanship begins on the 25-meter range, where the soldier is taught how to sight and aim their weapon. They are taught how to judge their performance. After that, they are ready for more rifle training and have gone over the fundamentals of rifle fire. In field firing, the soldier encounters more complicated conditions, they learn different firing positions, and how to allow for variations in terrain and distance. After many hours of training and reinforcement, the soldier is ranked according to the number of targets scored as hits. They are designated as either a sharpshooter, marksman, or expert.